The Presidential Election Petitions Tribunal has dismissed the petition filed by the PDP and its candidate in the 2019 presidential elections challenging the victory of President Muhammadu Buhari in its entirety. The five-man panel of the tribunal, led by Justice Muhammad Garba, gave the unanimous judgment on Wednesday. The tribunal dismissed the petition in its entirety, and the parties are to bear their respective cost. Other members of the five-man panel of the tribunal agreed to with the lead judgment. Justice Garba affirmed that President Muhammadu Buhari is the winner of the 2019 presidential election. The tribunal also dismissed Atiku Abubakar's claim that he won the election based on results allegedly transmitted into the INEC server. The chairman of the tribunal added that the petitioner failed to prove substantial non-compliance of the Electoral Act in the 11 states and complained that it had been marred by electoral malpractices. The People's Democratic Party, PDP, has rejected the judgment of the Presidential Election Petitions Tribunal, which held that the candidate of the All Progressive Congress, APC, President Muhammadu Buhari, won the February 23 polls. The PDP, in a statement on Wednesday by its National Publicity Secretary, Kola Ologbondiyan, said the verdict was proactive, a subversion of justice, and a direct assault on the integrity of the nation's justice system. The party said it was particularly shocked that the tribunal failed to point out to justice despite the flawless evidence laid before it. The opposition party said it will not lose hope or surrender to despondency or self-help, as their lawyers are optimistic about obtaining justice at the Supreme Court. And joining me in the studio is Raymond Kanabe, a lawyer, who's going to be telling us what he thinks about the outcome of this election tribunal.
Well, thank you for having me, Marianne. I think, first of all, I would like to commend Alhaji Atiku Abubakar for having proven to be a statesman, a complete statesman, as it were, having decided to explore the law to ventilate his grievances. And having said that, I also commend the judiciary for the expeditious manner they have been able to wrap up this matter within the constitutional time frame. At the end of the day, people win in court and people lose. It remains for the party who feels aggrieved with the decision to explore the appellate procedure to ventilate those grievances. And I like to understand that the PDP has indicated its displeasure with that decision and have indicated interest to appeal to the Supreme Court. They have 60 days from today to wrap up all the appellate process, and we'll find out what the Supreme Court will be saying by the end of that process.
Now, before now, I'm talking about previous governments, there have been election tribunals after every election cycle.
Yes.
But there seemed to be a lot of momentum around the Atiku Abubakar, you know, election tribunal versus the president.
Yes. Yes.
And there was some positivity coming from that camp, more like they knew something that we didn't know.
Yes.
Up until now.
Yes.
So a lot of people are wondering, I see a lot of people still surprised and a lot of people very angry, as opposed to the kind of reactions we used to get from other election tribunal rulings.
Well, two things. The first is this petition has been tagged the mother of all petitions. So naturally, you expect the level of anxiety that attended it to be lived. So secondly, the circumstances that brought about the petition, how the sort of campaign that Atiku ran and how many persons thought he would actually defeat Buhari at the ballot, and then it turned out to be the other way around. So those persons who held those beliefs carried it further throughout the process in court. So that momentum was still there. And then the whole server certificate issue, you get. So people had this sense that, oh, I think this petition will survive on at least one of the numerous grounds on which it was fought. But then people don't always know the position of the law. It is lawyers who will tell you that, okay, you might have your sentiment, but at the end of the day, those sentiments must bow to the provisions, settled provisions of the law. And we've heard from the five wise men today who have told us that the petitioners were unable to prove their case and they laid evidence, they made allegations against of criminal nature, without joining those persons whom those allegations were made against to be heard, and then thus leading to issue of fair hearing. And then they also told us that Mr. President actually qualifies to contest and for the election. But then we shouldn't miss out another interesting aspect of the tribunal's judgment today, which is the aspect whereby the respondent challenged Atiku's nationality, whether he's a Cameroonian or he's an Nigerian. And we saw how they said, well, that is outside our jurisdiction. What fixes this court jurisdiction is Section 138 of the Electoral Act. So to the extent that Atiku contested that election, and you have not joined issues with him on that, he has the right to present the petition. Mm-hmm. So his nationality, whether a Cameroonian or a Nigerian, is not what this court is going to decide. So all of a sudden, all the momentum that greeted the Cameroon, Nigeria, wherever, fizzled out in the decision. So I must commend the judiciary for the work they have done. Rightly or wrongly, we'll see what happens at the Supreme Court.
Finally, what do you think that would be, what would be the biggest thing that the PDP would be holding on to as they rehear this now that they have decided that they're going to the High Court?
Okay, I think one aspect they are going to put in a lot of weight is the issue of the card, the states, the position of the card reader machine vis-a-vis the voters register. Because I kept my ear to the ground today to know the pronouncement the court would make on the issue, on the place of the card reader machine. And then I discovered that they kind of skirted that issue and relied on the position as at 2010 and all the cases that were decided based on the 2010 amendment. They didn't factor the 2015 amendment to the act. And if you had the privilege to read the petitioner's final written address, they addressed the court that, my lords, the law has moved from the 2010 Amendment Act to the 2015 Amendment Act. And the 2015 Amendment Act enthroned the card reader machine to be the sole means of verification of voter who can eventually go on to vote. But the Court of Appeal did not make any definite pronouncement on that. So I would think that they will urge their lordship in the Supreme Court to look into that pronouncement and find out if their lordships were right in still enthroning the voters register as against the card reader machine.